Our Milky Way galaxy is destined to collide with the Andromeda galaxy. There's no stopping it, but we can predict what's going to happen. And thanks to the Hubble telescope, and more recently, the James Webb Space Telescope, we can study other galaxy collisions to learn more about what we can expect. Astronomers will be able to probe the earliest periods of galaxy formation by looking deep into space to see the first galaxies that form in the universe, only a few hundred million years after the Big Bang. Within the first year of operations, the James Webb Space Telescope will help researchers complete a more detailed sketch of the stellar life cycle, with high-resolution infrared light images of 19 galaxies. It will explore how stars, young galaxies, and dark matter work to create large-scale cosmic structure. The missing elements, which Webb will fill in, are largely in areas of the galaxies that are obscured by dust, regions where stars are actively beginning to form. Galaxies are a collection of stars, gas, dust, and dark matter held together by gravity. Their appearance and composition are shaped over billions of years by interactions with groups of stars and other galaxies. In shaping the universe, gravity builds a vast cobweb structure of filaments tying galaxies and clusters of galaxies together along faint bridges hundreds of millions of light years long.
We've been focusing on the photons, and we see them. They only tell us about part of the story. There was this fellow, Fritz Zwicky at Caltech, one of my heroes, who looked at a cluster of galaxies, and he realized that the galaxies are moving so quickly that in order to remain gravitationally bound, there has to be additional matter there holding them together. That's called dark matter. And his idea was ignored for about 40 years, but then Vera Rubin came along, and she studied the rotation of spiral galaxies and saw that they're spinning so quickly that they would fly apart unless there's extra stuff there, which we call dark matter. That's 85% of the matter in the universe, averaged over big distances, including galaxies and clusters of galaxies. That's 85% of what's there. And the photons tell us, and you might say, well, maybe the speeds give us the wrong impression, but they're independent pieces of evidence, like gravitational lensing. The dark matter in that cluster bends the light from a background galaxy, and that light then gets distorted into streaks. And you see them here. Look at them all. Look at all these streaks. These are gravitationally lensed background galaxies, and the amount by which they're lensed tells us that there's got to be a lot more matter there than just the visible matter.
The first mini-galaxies formed when the universe was just a few hundred million years old. Over time, these small galaxies interacted and merged to build up ever larger galaxies, including big spirals like our own Milky Way. This process isn't over yet. Based on data from the Hubble Space Telescope, the Milky Way is predicted to be on a collision course with Andromeda Galaxy. While scientists are confident that this collision is inevitable, the fate of the solar system in the event of a collision is currently unknown. Unless we have truly conquered space and have moved out among the stars, we will not be around to see it, since by the time the Sun will have engulfed the inner planets and consumed the Earth. But if some version of humanity does witness it, what will they witness? The actual collision will unfold over billions of years. But by human standards, it will proceed at a snail's pace. The light show, however, will be spectacular. Once the collision is done, the galaxies will have coalesced into one super galaxy. The universe is expanding, and most objects in it are moving away from one another. But the Andromeda Galaxy, or M31, is speeding towards the Milky Way at 68 miles per second. Right now, Andromeda is still 2.5 million light years away. It will take around 4 billion years to get here. Once it does, the galaxies will collide head-on with one another, move past one another, then sling back and begin to merge. This process itself will take billions of years to conclude, resulting in a massive elliptical galaxy. The Milky Way galaxy, Andromeda, and 52 other galaxies known as the Local Group are bound to each other gravitationally. Most of these galaxies are dwarf galaxies, with the center of the system somewhere between here and Andromeda. The next large galaxy, besides Andromeda, is called the Triangulum Galaxy. In fact, both of the largest galaxies have their own system of galaxies moving around them as satellites, much like the Moon orbits the Earth. According to NASA, Triangulum may become involved in the galaxy mashup as well.
I use images like this, and they are incredible high-resolution images. You see this brightness of the stars, the black of space. This is a photograph which is put together by the European Southern Observatory of the Milky Way, but taken from all points around the Earth, from the northern and southern hemisphere. So it's a beautiful picture of the Milky Way across the entire sky. So the right and left of this image are photographs of the Milky Way from the northern hemisphere, and the centre, and as you can see, if you know a bit of astronomy, the small and large Magellanic clouds. So this is the southern sky and the northern sky over here. You get a sense of the scale of a galaxy, 200 billion stars, perhaps as many as 400 billion. Now, we don't see the structure of a typical galaxy in a photograph like this from within, because we're inside looking out. So the next step out into the universe, and it's another excuse to show spectacular pictures, is to step out to some nearby galaxies. This is one of the high-resolution mosaics from the Hubble Space Telescope of a galaxy called the Whirlpool, which is a very well-known galaxy to our amateur astronomers in the Northern Hemisphere, at least, because you can see it with a very small telescope, even though it's 30 million light-years away. This photograph, by the way, is about 170,000 light-years across. And the Whirlpool's interesting because it's an interacting galaxy. So it's a galaxy in collision with a smaller dwarf galaxy, which is on the right of the image, that sort of yellow blob to the right. And what you're seeing there is the gravitational interaction, the collision between two galaxies. So each point of light in this fly-through is the mapped, measured position of a galaxy. But the relative positions of them are as measured. And I think images like this and visualizations of data like this give you a sense of the size and scale of the arena that we're talking about. These surveys allow us to estimate the number of galaxies that are visible to us, possibly, in the universe. It's called the observable universe. When we're faced about questions, one thing we have to know is that we're physically insignificant. The Milky Way galaxy itself is one galaxy amongst 2 trillion in the part of the universe we can see. The universe, we are very sure, extends way beyond.
Observational evidence indicates that almost every large galaxy has a supermassive black hole at its center. Both the Milky Way and Andromeda galaxies are no exception. Black holes are extremely dense regions of space, in which gravity is so intense that nothing, including light, can escape their powerful gravitational pull. As millions of stars orbit around the black holes at the center of our galaxy and Andromeda, there will be some mass loss. A small fraction of this matter will plow through the gravitational field surrounding the galaxies and head towards each other each time they pass by each other in a close pass. Eventually, these black holes will crash into each other. Any civilization within 3.25 million light years from us that has gravitational wave sensing technology on par with our current abilities would be able to detect the collision.
The input is a flat star field, nothing else. And then the mass and the spin of the black hole, nothing else. So all that distortion as we fly towards the black hole, you see this kind of strange mixing effect and the stars beginning to be pushed outwards in the field of view. That is the predicted curvature of the light rays following the curvature of space-time caused by the mass of the black hole. And we can sweep by the black hole and go into orbit around it. This brightness around the event horizon is interesting. In the theory in Einstein's theory, what you see there is you see light rays from the whole 360-degree sky focused, in fact, an infinite number of times onto the edge of the event horizon. So that brightness is, this is the whole 360-degree sky, a map of the whole visible universe, actually, surrounding you, mapped onto the event horizon.
But what about the stars of the Milky Way and Andromeda? Won't they clash into each other, creating massive explosions? With two galaxies cataclysmically clashing into each other, how could there be anything left? As hard as it is to imagine, scientists do not believe it is likely that stars will crash into each other, and although stellar conditions could occur, the chances of them occurring are very small. Once the galaxies collide, what is left of the solar system will most likely still be around. It will just be a part of a vast new galaxy. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.